Hello, and thanks for checking out this Screen Stories cutaway on Crisis and Climax. If you want to get your head around how this element fits into the narrative as a whole, then check out episode 2 of my 6 steps to writing a screenplay where we cover plot. Otherwise, let's get into it. As it sounds, the crisis is the low point in your film, or, thinking positively, it's the setup for your Act 3 payoff. I think of the crisis almost exclusively as the crisis decision, which is your protagonist's moment of true agency. He makes the decision that will lead him to his climax and demonstrates how he has grown to complete his arc and overcome his character flaw. He must decide to risk it all to have it all. An easy way to demonstrate what a crisis is and why we need it is to show what a plot looks like without it. After many adventures, Frodo takes the ring to Mount Doom and destroys it. Luke Skywalker partakes in a battle and makes the crucial shot, destroying the Death Star. You're missing that do or die moment where the protagonist must learn from their journey.
Let go.
They must gather all their strength and courage in one final effort to defeat the force of antagonism.
I can't carry it for you. But I can carry you! Come on!
The crisis decision should be a true dilemma, so your protagonist actively chooses to continue.
It's okay.
Yeah, it is okay.
It should give the clearest view of his true character and reveals the true story value of the film.
I would rather get murdered out here than spend the next half an hour with you. Can you please just pull over?
Goodbye, Ted.
This is a deliberately slow moment for your audience to suffer through with your protagonist. In actionable terms, you push your protagonist to his limits, challenging him and taking everything from him, leading to his crisis. But in doing so, you've equipped him with the strength of character to overcome this hurdle, and this takes us immediately to the climax. I'm handling these two elements in one video because they're so interlinked that they tend to run into one another, often taking place in the same scene. The crisis decision leads your character to their climax. It's your final showdown with your force of antagonism. This is the crowning reversal, but not necessarily a loud one. It just needs to be full of meaning, a value swing at maximum charge.
Are you deaf, McFly? Close the door and beat it.
No, Biff. You leave her alone.
All right, McFly.
Remember, we want to make our ending unexpected, yet inevitable. One way to make your ending seem inevitable is to foreshadow. During Luke's initial training, Obi-Wan offers similar encouragement to what he hears in the crisis.
Stretch out with your feelings.
We already know Luke is capable of letting go and using the Force.
Use the Force, Luke.
If logic allows, tie up subplots within the central plot's climax. This is a wonderful effect when one single action ties up all loose ends.
Mr. Healy, if you kill this man, I will never speak to you again.
Congratulations, buddy. You owe your life to a 13-year-old girl.
If you can't solve everything in one go, resolve the least important subplots first. In establishing what your climax will be, we can look at its relationship to the controlling idea. For this, we know we're looking for a value and a cause, giving us an X because Y statement. So to populate this very broadly from your climax, you simply find what your character achieves, the cause, and what they learned or overcame to achieve it, the value. So Luke learns to let go and trust himself, and in doing so, he defeats his force of antagonism. You see, the climax is the moment where you prove your controlling idea. So if you come up with an amazing plot twist or a scenario to end your film, you can always use that to help determine your controlling idea, which gives you the framework to really start building your character and plot. You see how a script may well be written or rewritten from the ending or climax. You may have a great idea for an ending, then build a world and character and plot to help give it maximum emotional value. Or you may have written your narrative, then find you have to add new elements at the climax to resolve all your plot points effectively. So you then need to go back and foreshadow everything you've added. So your crisis decision is a low moment, but your protagonist's moment of growth. It's where your lesson is learned, and it leads you to your climax. This is where your lessons learned are applied, and your controlling idea is proven. It's your largest value reversal. It should be unexpected, but with effective foreshadowing, it's also inevitable. And that's your crisis and climax in a nutshell. Did I miss something, or has anyone else got any great insight to add? Let me know in the comments. And please like, share, subscribe, and I'd love to get suggestions for upcoming episodes, so let me know if there's anything else you want to know more about. See you next time.